lay her wreath at the cenotaph in Whitehall in memory of those who died in two world wars. That will be on BBC One at 10:30 tomorrow morning. And then at 6:35 tomorrow evening, a special Songs of Praise for Remembrance comes from Newcastle upon Tyne. On BBC Two now, American Film Theatre, and Maximilian Schell stars in a psychological drama, The Man in the Glass Booth. And we've a feature film here on BBC One with the Saturday movie classic, Cool Hand Luke, introduced by Barry Norman.
Good evening. A few years ago, in an interview with that great organ of intellectual opinion, Playboy magazine, Paul Newman admitted, in his easygoing way, that he was typecast. Only the great, great actors have an inexhaustible source of variety, he said. Well, yes, Olivier has that, and so does Brando when he puts his mind to it. Newman probably hasn't. But even so, I think he was a little harsh on himself when he said he was typecast. True, the characters he plays are nearly always tough and independent, charming, charismatic and humorous. But those are the qualities that Newman brings with him to the job. They're his starting point. From then on, he invariably finds something else in the character he's playing, so that in the end what appears on the screen, though always unmistakably Paul Newman, is nevertheless Paul Newman plus. Inexhaustible source of variety? No. But a pretty plentiful source all the same, which ensures that his performances are never predictable. There's always just a touch of surprise. Cool Hand Luke, for which he won his fourth Oscar nomination, I think, reveals this more strongly than any of his other work. Certainly this is the Paul Newman we all knew and loved in The Hustler, Hud and Hombre, but there is, as you'll discover, an extra edge which makes his performance something rather special. In my opinion, he is, and has been for a long time, one of the very best actors in Hollywood, and what often obscures this fact is that he's so damn good-looking. David Niven always envied the way he could consume vast quantities of beer without ever putting on an ounce of weight. And Mrs. Newman, Joanne Woodward, once described her husband to me as never having had an ugly day in his life. She also said that one of the penalties of being married to him was that she was constantly being summoned to the door of their home to cope with teenage girls who wanted to know if Paul could come out and play. And by then he was already in his mid-40s and a grandfather. Well, I'm sure there must be compensations in being a sex symbol and a superstar, but such things do get in the way when what you really want is to be recognised as the talented actor that you also happen to be. Cool Hand Luke, his 27th film, made in 1967, was the one which, more than any of his earlier work, began to bring him that recognition.